So Eileen, when you're discussing with your patients who are possibly thinking about participating in a clinical trial, how do you go over with them the potential risks of participating in that particular study as well as the benefits?
So I think this is a very important topic, just the pros and cons of participation in a clinical trial and what that means to the person in front of us. So firstly, we'll provide a description of what the trial entails, and sometimes that's building on a standard treatment, sometimes it's a new drug that we haven't tested before or we're in the very early phases of testing. So a pretty detailed part of the discussion will be laying out the logistics of the trial. That's actually something that's very important to patients, as well as understanding the side effects that they might experience. They want to know, how many times a week they need to be there, how many days a week, whether they're short days or long days. So for example, with some studies, we'll do extra testing called PK studies or pharmacokinetic studies, where we'll be collecting certain bloods over a 24-hour period, maybe for 8 hours one day and the next morning, to understand how the drug is metabolized and eliminated. And that's important information to patients. I think another very important piece of information is they want to know, is their insurance going to cover it? Are they going to be out of pockets? Is the drug going to be supplied for them? And very typically, we will say that for the standard components that are part of a clinical trial, that's typically covered by insurance. And for example, the physician visits, some of the routine blood tests will be covered by insurance. That's usual. Things that are done very specifically for research. So for example, a research biopsy, taking a piece of the liver to look at the genetic makeup of the tumor, that might be a research-related test, and that would typically be charged to the study, as for example would be the experimental drug that's under study, that's provided as part of the trial. So they're very important considerations. We'll always advise patients that it's their right to participate in a trial. It's also their right not to participate in a trial, and it's their right, if it doesn't turn out to be the right fit for whatever reasons, to withdraw from the study. So with complete respect and understanding, we will acknowledge that decision and that sometimes it isn't the right fit for a given person, and that becomes apparent as the study goes on. An important part of the discussion is side effects and explaining what is known and often what is not known. And that is a big part of certainly early phase studies, to have a detailed understanding of what the side effects are. And this part of the consenting, I think, is sometimes overwhelming. It's often overwhelming to read 3 pages of side effects, and we trust and hope that a minority of those would ever touch the patient. But this is, part of how we have to frame our discussion. We don't want to minimize serious risks, and we always have to acknowledge that there are unexpected things that can happen as part of standard treatment, but certainly as part of trials, and make sure we do our duty in terms of informing a patient and their family. But not to be simplistic about this, but I often draw parallels from other settings in life where we go into things with a lot of potential risk, but we know at the end of the day they may be a very good thing for us.
Right. So I think what you're getting at, which is so true, is there's a lot to discuss with patients about clinical trials. And as far as the risks, in addition to the side effects of a particular new treatment, you've mentioned oftentimes it will just require a lot more intensive blood draws for these PK studies you mentioned. For more and more studies, they're actually mandating requiring one or more tumor biopsies, which are even a more invasive procedure because we're trying to get smarter in terms of understanding who is most likely to benefit from a treatment. How is the drug acting on the tumor in your body? And so I will tell patients that, participating in a study is not for the faint of heart, and it has to be something that you're really committed to participating in, because it will be quite a bit more intensive than just regular treatments. Of course, there's a potential for a high reward that is associated with that also. So again, I think it's communicating both the benefits and risks very clearly with patients.
And perhaps two other points, and I agree with everything you said there, Andrew, that part of our obligation in terms of the consent process is to ensure that a person understands what their alternative options are so that they can put the trial in context with their choices. So that's usually a key part of the discussion, and that's typically laid out in the consent form so that it's clear what the choices are, and we want to make sure that patients are aware that there's choices. There's always choices, right? Because it's a choice to participate in the first place. The second point I was going to mention is that there's often extra careful monitoring as part of a study, and that can be a reassurance to a person that we're going to look to see what the status of their cancer is, perhaps at a slightly sooner time point than we might otherwise, and that during the conduct of the study, they're going to have an extra blood test drawn, or perhaps tracings of the heart, or extra imaging to ensure that we're not overlooking an important negative signal.
When you mentioned before about being a little overwhelmed by the list of side effects for any novel treatments, which sometimes can be a long laundry list, I never minimize those, but I also tell patients that you've seen those commercials of a drug and sort of what scrolls across the screen in very small print is this very long laundry list of side effects. And I tell them, yes, these are ones that have been associated with the drug in a small number of patients. By no means am I expecting that to happen in your particular circumstance, but it is important that you be aware of them as you're making your decision about whether to participate or not.